I'm going to present the protocol and the objectives of a new project that we have initiated at IARC. This is called Cancer Screening in 5 Continents, or CanScreen 5 in short. And this project is essentially aimed at harmonizing cancer screening data collection to improve quality of cancer screening programs. As you know, quality in cancer screening is particularly important because in a screening program, there are always a group of men or women who face harms of screening. We know in screening, there will be false negative tests, false positive tests, and some of the men and women will face the consequences of these. But still, we screen women for breast cancer and cervical cancer, and we screen men and women for colorectal cancer, essentially because the evidence shows that the benefits, they outweigh the harm of screening. And of course, these are cost-effective in most of the countries. So that is why we recommend screening in for certain cancers. But then there are certain cancers where screening can cause a lot of harm. One of those harms is overdiagnosis. A classical example of overdiagnosis due to screening is in South Korea, where men and women were being screened for thyroid cancer using ultrasound. And as you can see, because of screening, a large number of thyroid cancers have been detected, and many of these cancers detected in men and women must have been treated with surgery, and the patients have faced the consequences of complications, and they have been put on maybe lifelong medications. But if you look at the line, right, which is there at the bottom, showing the thyroid cancer mortality, in spite of detecting so many cancers and treating them, the mortality has remained stable. So this is the classic concept of overdiagnosis. That means detecting those cancers that are innocuous and will not be clinically obvious or cause death in the lifetime of that person. So the whole idea of quality in cancer screening is to ensure that the harms are minimized and the benefits are maximized. Now, how do we do that? There is a very specific protocol of quality improvement in cancer screening. That protocol essentially tells us to measure certain indicators. And these indicators, we divide them into structural indicator, process indicator, and outcome indicators. Structural indicators are essentially about the service provisions. Say, for example, number of health centers providing screening tests, number of trained provider being involved in the project. So these are structural indicators. The process indicators measure the process of screening, starting from invitation to screening to performance of the further assessment of the screen positives, and finally treatment of those cancers or precancers detected through screening. So there are certain indicators that measure the process of screening, and finally the outcome measures are essentially looking at the number of cancers or the precancers detected through screening. So if I can give you some examples of these indicators, the screening coverage is a process indicator. The compliance of the screen positive men or women to further assessment is again another process indicator. And outcome indicator, classic example is the detection rate of precancers or cancers. Now, just measuring these indicators is not enough. These indicators, they need to be compared with certain standards that have been already documented and accepted for the program. And when you compare the indicators to standards, then you understand the gaps that are there in the screening program. And then you can plan for specific steps to reduce or minimize those gaps. And then only the quality improvement occurs. So this is a continuous process of measuring the activities and looking at the indicators, comparing them with standards, and taking actions. The key issue here is that every screening program should have a health information system that allows it to measure these indicators. The whole concept of cancer screening in five continents came from the project that we implemented in 28 European Union countries. We measured the screening activities in these 28 European Union countries, and we targeted breast, cervical, and colorectal cancer screening. And the final document, which we called the European Screening Report, it was published in 2017, and it essentially documents the changes in status of screening program implementation over a decade in different countries, how they have very systematically implemented screening, starting from pilot, then gradually expanding it to regional programs, and then finally rolling it over across the country. So that we documented. We also documented the program organization in different countries. And most important is that for the first time, such a large number of countries provided data in a harmonized way to estimate the process and outcome indicators for screening for three different sites. So this was a huge exercise. The entire report is available online. And as you can see in this particular table, you can see except Greece, which we can see the cross marks across all the columns. All other countries, they provided data. And data was collected, as I said, for breast cancer, cervical cancer, and colorectal cancer, because these are the cancers that have been recommended for screening in European context. And for each site, we collected information about the screening protocol, screening organization, screening quality assurance, and this kind of information, which we call qualitative information, using a questionnaire. So for example, Austria, and as you can see, all the tick marks, that means they provided the questionnaire for breast cancer, and we know we have the qualitative information. The quantitative information, which is essentially the performance of screening program, was collected again using another questionnaire, which is called data tables. And as you can see, for breast cancer, almost all the countries except two, they provided data. So this is how we collected the data from each country. And when we analyzed the data, it was a huge amount of data. And if you look, go through the report, you will see more than 100 tables like this. So this table is essentially showing the detection rate of adenomas, which is a very important performance indicator of screening, colorectal cancer screening, by stratified by the test used and by sex of the participants. But then just think of a very busy program manager. For a busy program manager to make sense out of this kind of table is very difficult. I mean, what is the message that this table is providing to a program manager? So then we decided to transfer these kind of tables into more visual way, and following the example set by our GlobalCan project, which all of you know, we converted this data into maps or into interactive charts like this. So the same table that you have seen in the previous page, now when we convert it into a systematic chart like this, so here it is again showing the detection rate of adenomas in 50 to 79 year old men and women among men in various programs in the European Union countries. And here you can see quite obviously that there are two countries, the Poland and Czech Republic, that have much higher detection rate as compared to the other countries. Obviously, the next question that a program manager has to ask is, why is this difference? And again, it is not very difficult to answer these questions because we have also information about their program protocol. So we know that Poland and Czech Republic, they use colonoscopy to screen, whereas the other countries, they use fecal immunochemical tests to screen. So obviously, colonoscopy will be detecting many more adenomas as compared to FIT tests. So it is very easily, the explanation is very easy to get, and when we look at this data in this way. So the CANSKID 5 project, it has three major ambitions. The first one is to collect and disseminate information on cancer screening practices and programs globally. So for example, if somebody is interested to know how Russian Federation is screening their women for breast cancer, what is the protocol, what is the organization of the program, how is the quality assurance being implemented. So all this information one person can get on a single website. So that is our first objective. The second objective is to harmonize the data collection for evaluation of screening programs. All of you know that the performance indicators are used in maybe in every screening program, but then the definitions are very different. The same performance indicator may have a different denominator when it is being used in a program in Russian Federation or in a program in Denmark. So we want to make sure that this kind of screening program data collection is harmonized. And more importantly, these performance indicators are estimated in a harmonized manner so that data is comparable. And finally, we want to work with the countries to organize their health information system better so that there is a culture of measuring the activities and assessing the quality of the screening programs with the final objective to improve the quality. So these are the three main objectives. And the final outcome of this project will be something like this. Many of you are quite conversant with the GlobalCAN project. So the outcome will be by the countries or by the sites, cancer sites. So if you want to know the screening program that is there in, say, for example, Austria, you'll have to go to Austria and click on this, and then you will get all the information on cancer screening programs in Austria. Or you may decide to go by the cancer site. So if you want to know more information globally, what is happening on breast cancer screening, you'll have to click on this. So this is how a fact sheet will look like for breast cancer. So this is the fact sheet for breast cancer showing the year of initiation of the screening program in different countries, the different screening protocols, the examination coverage. So at one place, you get all this information. And on the right-hand side, the same information or similar information you can see in maps, in more visual formats. So how do we actually go about getting this data? So we contact a person who is preferably the coordinator of the program in the Ministry of Health, or somebody in the academic in an academic institution of repute that is working in close collaboration with the ministry to support the cancer screening programs. So we identify a collaborator in each country who is ready to collect and share data for this project. And the data collector will have to fill in two different forms. And then there is this qualitative form that is essentially looking at asking questions about program policy, the protocol, program organization, implementation, financing, quality assurance, and whether there is a separate policy to bring in the high-risk or vulnerable population under screening program. So if a country has a breast cancer screening program, the data provider has to fill in the questionnaire related to breast cancer screening. The second questionnaire is essentially to collect the data across the screening program, which will allow us to estimate the key performance indicators. So as you can see in the table, we are asking what is the total target population, what is the total number of, say, for example, women invited for cervical cancer screening, what is the number of women who have been screened, what is the screen positivity. So this kind of information across the entire screening process. But then we understand the challenge of collecting data from a screening program, and especially across the entire screening continuum. So even a country has a minimum set of data, say for example, number of women screened for cervical cancer and what is the test positivity, they can provide that data. So it's not that we are asking every country to provide data across the entire screening program. And then one can submit data by regions, or one can submit data across the countries, the national data. So this will finally allow us to estimate the different coverage, like screening coverage, participation to screening, participation to the to further assessment, and then the final outcome measures like detection rates and positive predictive values, depending on how much data, what is the quality of data that we get from the different countries. So once we get this data from a particular country, that means the data provider submits the data is looked into by our secretariat for completeness, for validity, for consistency, and then we have a scientific committee. So the data goes to the scientific committee for peer review. Once the scientific committee has peer reviewed, and if they have any questions, we will get back to the data provider to resolve those questions. So once the data has been approved by the scientific committee, we will again go back to the data provider to tell him or her that this is what the scientific committee has accepted, and this is what your data looks like. So once it is finally accepted by the data provider, then only it will be published in the website. So once it is published, this data can be used to create this kind of graphs. So for example, here you can see the participation, the invitation coverage for breast cancer screening programs across different countries. So it is easily comparable. Or if you the data may be going into a table, so one can generate this kind of tables. One can generate maps like this, or there are other visual methods of presentation. So the point here is that the data that is being submitted will not be immediately transferred to the platform. There is a peer review process, and once the peer review process is finalized, once the data provider accepts our final version, then only it will be transformed into this kind of platform. So to summarize the role of a national collaborator who is going to provide data, obviously to share the screening data for the respective country. If he or she is not from the Ministry of Health, we'll be expecting him or her to get a mandate from the Ministry of Health to share the data. And then that person will get an access to the web portal, and then will be involved in analyzing the data. And of course, when the publications come out, they will be contributing to those publications. So it's just not collecting data or sharing data. There are the person or the collaborator will be actively involved in the entire process of data analysis and final publication. And one of the major thrust of this program is training. So there will be an e-learning module which will be available on the platform. This is essentially to capacity build in cancer screening quality assurance. Though it is targeted primarily to the program managers, but then the providers involved in cancer screening, the policymakers, they can also benefit from this 2 hour of e-learning session. So this e-learning session is divided into multiple small video presentations, and then it is covering the principles of cancer screening program, the principles of quality improvement, why is quality improvement very important in cancer screening program, what is health information system and how to utilize a health information system for quality improvement of a program, what are performance indicators and how do we define these performance indicators, and finally, how to implement quality improvement in a real program. So all these will be available freely on the platform. So as a final message, so the CanScreen 5 is essentially going to contribute to this what we call DIKW pyramid, which starts with collection of data. That means we measure the performance, we observe what is going on, but that itself is not enough. We need to analyze that data, categorize it, and put it in the right context to understand the information that is coming out from the data. And once that information is used to understand the quality of the program, say for example, if the detection rate is too low, what may be the possible reasons for the low detection rate? Or if the screening coverage is low, why is the program not being able to achieve the appropriate coverage that's expected out of it? So we need to not only look at the key performance indicators, we need to try to understand what are the gaps and what best we can do to improve quality. And finally, is the wisdom is all about making decisions to improve the quality of the program. Thank you very much.